माननीय उप सभापति जी, मैं कृतज्ञ हूँ आपका कि ऐसे अहम मामले की डिस्कशन पे आपने मुझे परमिशन दी बोलने के लिए। एट द वेरी आउटसेट आई विल लाइक टू कन्वे टू एवरीबडी दैट फॉर 40 ईयर्स आई हैव बीन सर्विंग इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट इज इंडियन आर्मी वेयर वी कैन इवन डू समरी कैपिटल पनिशमेंट और समरी कैपिटल एग्जीक्यूशन इन केस ऑफ कावर्डिस इन फेस ऑफ एनिमी टू मेंटेन द लॉ एंड ऑर्डर देर आर मेनी फैक्टर्स मे बी स्टेट ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट पॉपुलेशन इन इट सेल्फ upbringing of an individual to form the personality of the person, his parentage, his environment, and even genetic predilection. But maintaining all those factors, we train to maintain the discipline, we make the bent of mind to be discipline loving. At the same time, we create environment and conditions that our soldiers, they don't indulge in indiscipline and law and order. Not only that, to save the motherland, to save the mother nation, we get killed in the delivery of our duty, but at the same time, we say that discipline has a very big factor, and that factor is deterrent punishment and exemplary punishment. Deterrent punishment is when the criminal repeats that crime, he should be scared that you will meet the same punishment. And exemplary punishment is when the criminal is given punishment, the others should feel, it should be a deterrence to others that if you do it, you will also get the same punishment. Not only that, when we administer the punishment, in the process of cashiering, we take the offend maker in the public, remove his rank, remove his belt, and divest him of all the facilities and the benefits what he should have got if he would have retired honorably. As far as capital punishment is concerned, in this country, one of my honorable was saying that 60% of the world population still comes under the countries, in the countries which administer capital punishment. The crime rate is minimum in Saudi Arabia because the punishment is highly deterrent and I will say even brutal in that country. But in China also, crime rate has come reasonably down once they started giving capital punishment even for economic offenses. As far as our country is concerned, that is very correct that not only in the case of murder or assassination, in case of mutiny, waging war against the nation, even a criminal conspiracy, and the state to which I belong, Haryana, we have instituted capital punishment for rape and for rape and for murder of a child. Under these situations where a parliament has been attacked, under these situations where a living prime minister has been assassinated, not one, many political assassinations, and we say that abolish the capital punishment. This goal seems to be very unrealistic. How unrealistic? The countries which have abolished capital punishment, their crime rate has come very low. Their other environmental conditions, education, employment, and motivational levels are very high. I will bring some instances in Haryana. One more thing I will request the August House, that crime should not be given a caste tinge. The people who are languishing in jails, their caste should not be counted. Their crime and the magnitude of crime should be seen. And for your kind information, in Haryana jails, the maximum people who are in jails are from general category, not from SC or ST. Therefore, I request that crime should not be given a caste tinge. A study has been carried out in Stockholm, Sweden. And a doctor, being a doctor in fact, I would like to dilate upon that. They say there is a specific DNA gene which is compulsive to repeat the crime. And in Haryana, there are examples. You go to jail, you come out on parole, you again commit suicide and this crime, homicide, and you are again likely to go to jail. All those criminals on their head, if it is more than 50,000 reward, they are habitual offenders and very hardcore criminals. I quote an example. One girl with her husband killed the complete family, 12 murders. And in Haryana jails now, once I say there is a pressure from Uttar Pradesh of encounter or punishing the criminals, they have all shifted to their parent state, that is Haryana, and they have surrendered. Now under these situations, if you keep living the dreaded and habitual offenders, you are inviting law and order. Today, budget was being discussed, and it was told by some of my honorables that India had 25% of world business at one time before the invaders came, and it reduced to considerably low at some stage. Now, if we had 25% of world share of business, our law and order and our civil administration was superb, even in Prithviraj Chauhan's time. Then what went wrong? Went wrong was law and order. We couldn't defend the nation. We couldn't defend that society. We couldn't defend that economy. Therefore, to defend that, deterrent punishment to the enemies of nation, deterrent punishment to the enemies of society, deterrent punishment to the potential criminals is a must, so that you can maintain the law and order. Otherwise, there will be chaos. And at one stage, the dreaded dictator Adolf Hitler had commented that democracy is synonymous with chaos. As far as our country is concerned, when our independence, Indian independence was being debated in British Parliament, at one stage, the opposition leader, who was erstwhile major from British Indian Army, their wartime prime minister, but when we got liberated, he was not the prime minister, he once commented that to rule the colored races is white man's burden. Therefore, they don't deserve independence because they are incapable of governing themselves. And how this chaos came subsequently, in British times, the murderer used to go to gallows, that also publicly, within 2 years. In army, we institute a punishment, we institute justice, I say, and we deliver it within 2 years. There are countries, even in United States and UK, the murderer goes to electric chair or execution or cyanide capsule within 1.5 years or within 2 years. As chairman Haryana Public Service Commission, I was selecting judges, and there were 3 high court judges as members, and I just commented that justice delayed is justice delivered. And one of my friend judges, who was ex-army and he was with me even in armed forces, he commented, "Nahi, General Saab, justice delayed is justice delivered." I asked, "How come that?" He says, "Vakilon ko paise dete dete court ke chakkar lagate lagate 15 saal 20 saal beet jate hain, unke ghutne toot jate hain, unki pocket ka money khatam ho jata, wo apna aap baith jate hain ghar pe. That is the justice delivered. Now if this is the state of affairs, how can we run a populous nation of 132 crores? And 132 crores, my friend Honorable Tamtaji brought this bill, and he says, as per the record, after 2015, only 5 people have been hanged. Now, out of a population of 132 crores, only 5 hanged. That also Menon, Afzal Guru, the Sajmal Kasab, those waged war against the nation. Then it is minuscule. Practically, this punishment stands abolished if this is the proportion of executions. Here, if you keep low punishment, this is the state, because as I mentioned, what Churchill advocated, our law and order condition has come to such an impasse that Congress government diluted the punishment. Otherwise, if it would have remained deterrent, we became humane. Though that was a wrong statement that Britishers brought the death penalty. No, even Raja Maharajas used to give death penalties during ancient times also. Death penalty has become a must because our sanskars have rather been adulterated. Such a penalty has come into being because crime rate has increased, because of certain, I will say, population outburst, I will say faulty education, faulty sanskar, increased unemployment, which we will now deal with, and because of this computerization and everything, jobs have gone out and people have taken to crime. That thing has to be looked into. I was doing a military exercise near Sarand Canal, and I met an old man of 102 years of age, and he was quite hale and healthy, and his son was sick. He told me that criminals with the bodies in their legs used to be brought to Sarand Canal, and the Sarand Canal was dug by criminals, all Qaidis. Earlier it used to be Qaid ba mashakkat, or rigorous imprisonment. Now those Qaidis have become a liability on the nation. He has committed a crime, and you say give him life imprisonment so that he is a liability on taxpayers and he generates more criminals. One Darogaji was killed by a crowd, and opposition parties sided with the people who killed him. His name was, I believe, Maheshyam Batala. If that is the state of affairs, Europe did a very good thing when they occupied Australia, when they occupied America, Canada. They shifted all their criminals who were in jails to those countries. Like our used to be a Kala Pani, their Kala Pani was Australia, Canada, and America and Latin America. Now, we don't have that alternative also. At least we should put them to proper, rigorous imprisonment, and that should be a physical, not a torture, physical work, so that they are, we can make a garland canal. We have that many of prisoners. We harp upon that we are poor people, we cannot afford and all that, but we are nurturing them in jails. We are giving all the facilities. Under these situations, the law and order of this country will not improve. Sabhapati ji, the reports are from China, the reports are from Saudi Arabia. There have been researches also on criminality, and as I mentioned, there is a specific DNA. के क्राइम क्रिमिनल करने से पहले बोलता जरूर है एंड दे हैव ए टेंडेंसी टू कमिट क्राइम टाइम एंड अगेन सच इंडिविजुअल्स इन द सोसाइटी हैव टू बी एलिमिनेटेड लाइक यू एलिमिनेट ए रेबिट डॉग यू एलिमिनेट बैड भ्रूण्स इवन इन सीड्स हूसोएवर ही मे बी व्हाटसोएवर रेस कास्ट और creed he may be, he is a liability, a blot on the society, on the nation, and he is going to obstruct the march of the nation with sabka saath, sabka vikas. Wo kisi ke saath nahi hai, wo sabhi ke khilaaf hai. Aise logon pe mercy rakhna, aise halat mein, jabki hamare har tarah ke crimes, as I mentioned, Kashmir Assembly attacked, Parliament attacked, Prime Minister is assassinated. Under these situations, if we lower our guard, tomorrow you will say there is no requirement of the guards who are standing outside, there is no requirement of the army. In 1962, we had debacle because the first Prime Minister thought, what is the need of army? Let them do kheti badi. That was the state of affairs till Chinese knocked us, and that's why we could defend ourselves in 65. And we marched up to Lahore. I am proud of, because I served in that battalion, 3rd Jat Battalion, walked even up to conquered Dograi and walked up to Lahore. Such was the situation. In 71 also, we were, rather I will say, we administered a semi-fatal blow to the criminal nations. Under these situations, I will advocate that as far as the existing provision is concerned, it is in the rarest of the rare cases, or I will say even rarest of the rare of the rarest cases. Because after 2015, only 4 executed or 5 executed. That is too low a ratio. And I advocate that this capital punishment should not only stand, it should be enhanced, and repeated offenders should be executed. And if you do that, you will follow a role model organization, that is armed forces, which are one of the biggest factors to keep this nation intact, whatsoever may be the calamity, whatsoever may be the aatai or enemy. Under these situations, I strongly oppose this bill. Thank you very much for giving me a patience.
Dhanyawad, Dr. D.P. Vats ji.